Hey guys, I'm James.
I'm Fish.
And we are going to be reacting to episode 3 of Pacific Rim, The Black. You know, just the usual stuff. If you like it, press the like button. If you really like it,
you just gotta press that subscribe button as well.
Hell yeah. Just do that thing. The thing. And we're gonna talk about some science. So if you like science, stick around. Usually we have a pretty in-depth science discussions at the end if there's anything interesting to talk about.
We're not as distracted by the anime or the animation during it. So
we do talk a lot about what we see in the anime though. So if you like science, like don't skip around, watch the whole thing through because we will be usually covering things as we see them as well. There'll be a lot of little tidbits and everything. So. Boom.
I love the seismometer thing. It's very cool.
Yeah, I like that it makes Australia, and you know, it's also like used to detect the kaiju, I imagine.
And they come out of a fault line when you're coming out.
Also true. Yeah.
Related to seismology a little bit.
Yep.
I wonder if we can see anything from this intro that would indicate.
So what are we looking for?
Maybe any like insights to the story.
Fair.
Are those missiles inside the...
Yeah, that was strange. I mean, it's definitely not the Jaeger, though, because they were, like, separated in offset. It was weird. There was some sort of weird offset there. Who knows what was going on there?
It could be drifting, yeah.
Yeah.
So they still don't have power cells, so... Not in a good position.
Correct. Maybe that boy is a power cell.
I wonder if they can hand crank, like, power it up.
I wonder how long that would take.
Like, actively split the atoms back down to hydrogen if it's a fusion cell.
Yeah. Oh.
Huh.
Interesting. So signs of life still.
Do you think he should use his little necklace to shine a light to make sure they notice him?
Yes. I mean, the Jaeger, I think, is still somewhat active. They probably, like, blare a horn.
Yeah. Probably doesn't use that much power in old air horn. This kid still doesn't have clothes. It's probably cold in there. It's metal.
Yeah, probably. Or really hot.
Do you have a choice? Yeah. There.
You...
It's not like you can say, don't come for us anymore if they're sketchy.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
I wonder how much computational power it takes for this AI to go. They're on reserve power, but yet it's still running normally.
Yeah, I mean, it's probably a lot, but it's also probably not that much compared to actually moving a giant machine.
That's a good point.
Yeah.
When you're moving a giant machine like that, you can probably recover a lot of energy in terms of like, so like say you lift the leg back up, you can probably get a lot of the energy by putting it back down, like if you reharvest it. Like regenerative braking legs.
Yeah. But also it's like a human, so I feel like the mechanics of it probably aren't that efficient either to move around.
Well, it's a lot more rigid of a structure for sure. So maybe you could get a lot more energy back. Like when you're stopping, you could like have regenerative braking in the hinge of your legs and perhaps the stop.
Yeah. You're gonna have a lot of like energy loss to heating and stuff though too.
Yeah. I mean, it's something, right? But for the amount of mass it has.
Yeah.
Eggs. Yummy, yummy.
Yeah, kaiju eggs.
Probably high in protein. It's glowing.
Yeah.
But like we said, bioluminescence doesn't necessarily equate to having higher energy necessarily.
This is true.
But where we typically see bioluminescence in nature is in, you know, where it's very dark. So like a deep ocean.
Yeah, but it's mostly to like attract prey and stuff like that.
Yeah. But
which is interesting.
In this case, what would be attracted to? Why would people go through the glowing death thing? Maybe on their planet.
Well, they're grabbing them right now. I don't know. But yeah, I do wonder what the advantage is. It could just be energy. But
did you just say the butterfly?
Yeah, he's eating it. Yeah, I saw it.
They could stole it.
They could have been stolen. They do look trained, though, possibly.
They have to eat somehow.
I wonder what kaiju would taste like.
Well, people typically say all meat tastes like chicken.
Oh, he is... He's just ready to go join his friend here. Oh. Oh.
That gun is
pretty big. Why? That's not going to do anything to this
thing.
And
it has legs. Why does it glow? Is it irradiated? That's a lot of radiation.
I don't know.
It looks like a salmon almost. Oh.
Yum.
Oh my god, it came out of the gills?
Yeah.
RPG!
I feel like an RPG's not going to do anything to this thing either. It's huge.
It looks like a high-tech RPG for sure.
True. Yeah, it could have good penetration. It didn't look like it had a tip on it, though. Well, I guess a little bit.
We don't know what's...
It didn't do anything to it. It just stunned it for a sec.
You'd think it would have like a sabot round or something.
Yeah. It looks like it's just a flat nose.
Open but wide.
It does kind of glow a little bit. It glows like they do, so that's kind of interesting.
Yeah, maybe it's the same tech. Oh, that must not be good. Oh!
Nice.
Definitely a weakness.
Yeah, get inside the kind of tough exterior.
I wouldn't do that.
Try to stuff it with your leg?
A lot of animal. I mean, it has a lot of mass, first of all, and a lot of animals still can react post-mortem.
Yeah.
You killed two of their guys.
Boom. Yeah. Oh, he's gonna shoot him. She's kinda cool looking. He looks like he is a secondary character who's ready to die at any moment. She looks like a main character.
She's brutal.
Yeah. How'd you walk that far?
Ah.
Uh-huh. Ooh, she doesn't trust you. Oh, boy.
She's watching the kid.
I'm telling you, this kid is a kaiju.
I don't trust her.
Yeah.
She doesn't trust him either.
I don't trust her because she doesn't trust them. I don't think she's actually a bad person. Mm. Well, this is a hike.
Where do they get the gas? Or maybe it's electric. Or hydrogen.
It could be electric, yeah. Yeah.
I love
I guess we could look for an exhaust, maybe. That would give us a hint.
That's a good point. But diesel, if it's diesel, maybe they would just use some diesel fumes, some smog. Perhaps.
Yeah.
In Japan, oh no, this is Australia. Australia uses diesel, or do they use gas more? I can't tell.
I don't know. If anyone here is from Australia, you can let us know in the comments. You are
Why
lying.
Why not tell them the truth?
I think they don't want to say that they have a Jaeger, is what it is.
They left the Jaeger behind for sure.
Yeah.
Oh, I guess if they say they looked for it in that power facility, that means they... That would indicate they're looking for power cells, and perhaps that'd lead them to Jaeger.
Yeah.
Egg snatchers. Do you think they grow kaiju to be, like, old enough just so they can kill them and then eat them?
Yes.
Like, a kaiju farm.
This guy I don't trust.
Cool haircut. A little bit.
He's got too much of a beard. We don't trust people with beards.
Yeah, it's disgusting.
Yeah. Gross. We hate beards.
That's rough.
You just outrun a kaiju?
Maybe if there's a lot of them split up.
some are sacrificial.
I mean, look how many barrels of maybe oil that is.
Nice. Do they have... No, they don't have their suits on. Okay. I was wondering if they had them on, like, underneath their clothes.
Everyone's noticing the shoes.
Yep. Man, he is just an angry dude.
He's definitely gonna die.
Mm-hmm.
She's hard.
Yeah.
I mean,
I like her.
She looked a kaiju straight in the face and blasted an RPG in it.
Right in his mouth, too. Yeah.
They have some pretty advanced tech. Is that a limo? That's a Mad Max energy.
Yeah.
Definitely not efficient. I mean, if you're going across a desert, I mean, you only need a minimal size tire. You don't need, like, massive mud boggers to go across the desert.
True.
Okay, that's just like mechanical disadvantage for you.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's no.
That is, yeah.
Those are mud boggers.
Oh, do they have a Jaeger too?
Oh.
I wonder.
A lot of parts to fail. Wow, he sort of has like an Attack on Titan jacket. It sort of looks like that. Like of the scout.
Yeah, it does. It does look like one. Like a scout jacket, yeah. Or not really a scout jacket, the cadet jacket. Or the garrison jacket, the tan one.
Yeah. Where is it going to... Is it a power cell?
Oh. Yep.
Oh, they're going to steal them.
Years of energy. Okay. It has to be a fusion or something.
And they broke one.
Uh-huh. He's letting on too much. Oh. But we only have two. We don't have four eggs.
The pulling power of that limo must be intense. Considering it's moving a massive part across sand.
Yeah.
The thing is, sand, like, deviates pretty well. Like, you'll dig into sand, so it requires a lot of power to tow across sand.
Yeah.
You need a Duramax. Or 3,500. I don't know my trucks. An F-350. There we go.
I don't know anything about trucks. Boom. Man, people are so aggressive.
I mean, you gotta be, right? It's almost like Mad Max.
He only gets one power cell.
I mean, that's fair. You think they'd secure something like that down, then...
Oh! She is gonna kill everyone. Yeah, I feel like they're way more well-armed. I don't know.
You can't...
They're not in their base.
No.
Oh boy.
They're gonna steal the truck?
It sounds like it. Oh boy. This guy's kinda creepy. Yeah, say goodbye. Uh-oh. Oh, got a shootout now. Nice. Just kill everyone. Wow, they are efficient.
What? This is the worst bodyguard ever. How do you know to duck, too?
I don't know. Wow, they wiped them out very quickly.
That truck is...
And the truck went nowhere? Oh. Nice. Take his power cell.
That's risky. Why would you do that? Like, you could have... The trunk isn't going to stop a bullet. That could have damaged the power cell.
Yep.
What about the briefcase?
Easily.
Oh, they're letting him have the briefcase.
Oh, he shot the eggs, though.
That's...
Boom. He's going to get killed. For sure.
What? What?
This dude is so persistent.
He's sweating, too.
Yeah.
No, not
so. I guess they're like, she's sort of with them. Are the soldiers with her and he's like something else?
Maybe she's a mercenary. It's hard to say.
Yeah, because he's like your little friends or something, right? Which would imply that.
Oh, maybe... I think he's implying the little kids. Maybe had
something. Oh, yeah, you could be right there. That's true.
Because they try. Didn't that whole shootout happen because. No, well, I mean, it was that dude's fault. Like, the dude shot first. Because they kicked him.
It's also, it's also like, do they know where the first shot came from? Usually that stuff just gets chaotic really fast, right?
Yeah, that's true. I mean, but it was ultimately their fault. The guy could have attested.
Interesting. So he's hearing voices.
I think they gave him a drug.
That's possible, yeah.
Oh, he's losing it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, man.
Is it psychological torture or is it chemical psychological?
Probably both.
It's like he's drifting, but like not.
Mm-hmm. It is very similar to the drift that we saw before.
Do you think he's drifting with him right now to, like, interrogate? Because that could be a pretty huge play.
That would be effective, yeah.
Because
it's looking like that might be the case.
That door looked like an entrance to, like, one of those, like sort of the architecture.
You think they have, like, a Jaeger head or something?
Yeah, just, like, the central area.
Yeah.
Oh, he's definitely drifting with them. But maybe it's, like, a one-way drift. So he doesn't get any information from them. That's really messed up.
Yeah.
Oh, he sees a Jaeger helmet.
Mm-hmm. He's just chilling, watching what goes down. Oh.
He's making him relive this, too. That's a real...
Yeah. Fuck. Yeah.
I mean, we don't really know. He could just be spilling all this out, but I don't know why he would. It's definitely drifting.
Yeah, there's no reason why he would.
Or is it in his head?
Oh, yeah. So this is what they did not want to show them. They had a Jaeger.
Oh, he definitely just spilled all of that. So he just spilled all that. He just told that entire story.
I guess so. I'm definitely a little confused as to what went down here.
Huh? Oh, And we saw when they entered the camp, he had a key of those, a key ring of all those Jaegers. So he must have multiple Jaegers.
Oh, yep, they were drifting.
Dang. That's pretty huge. I mean,
yeah.
Honestly, it would be a breach of some constitutional right, at least in America, to, you know, reach into their mind, for sure.
Yeah. But definitely like a cool technique there.
It's interesting that they can do a one-way transfer, because you wouldn't think, I mean, maybe there's some protocol for it. Like, if your neurons mesh, they mesh, right? You don't think they would be, like, a diode, but for, like, neurons, like, you only get memories passing one way versus the other. But, I mean, neurons are complex, so I'm sure you could develop some program to, like, make a one-way transfer.
That's what I was wondering, if there's, like, some sort of, like, AI filter going on, or some sort of assistance to affect his mind. I mean, I was always under the impression that they're not, like, that they're going through some sort of intermediary, right? Like, some sort of, like, AI or something like that to assist the process, so.
So, put in terms of, you know, like, computer technology. So, you don't think it's, like, P2P, like, person-to-person. Do you think it's, like, person-to-server, person-to-server? So, you could have...
Yeah, basically.
But based on that, you could have, like, multi-person drifts, like, two-plus people drifts.
Possibly, yeah. I mean, we do know one of the guys drifts with a kaiju.
Yeah. Oh, do we know?
So, and I don't think those are like, you know, I don't know how much the neurons are, like, you know, how easy it would be to bridge that way. I think it does probably go through, you know, some sort of intermediary, but I don't know for sure. Yeah. I mean, I'm sure it's probably somewhere. I'm sure there's like a guidebook or something that talks about this stuff.
Yeah. It's really interesting that, you know, I don't know, something about, I totally lost my train of thought there, but basically, them meshing together, it's just an interesting concept.
Yeah, it makes me wonder how it would be done.
That's my thought. Like, they would have to develop this technology after the Jaegers were built, right? Because the Jaegers seem to be like a government sort of built thing, or military-based thing, but they have access to it. Or maybe military would have some interrogation techniques based on Jaeger technology, and they just got a hold of it. But the other alternative is they develop this technology themselves, which means they'd have to have an intimate knowledge of like how the whatever language or whatever programming thing is. It could be that it's like a higher level of programming, and they just have to do a few basic things, and then it does whatever they want.
It's also possible that it is like a straight connection, like a P2P, like you were saying, but this guy's just like an alpha chat, and he's able to dominate his mind.
Oh,
like,
I see.
Pretty easily. That's possible too, maybe.
I wonder.
Like, it's just something he does.
I wonder if you could have something like a mesh network. So, you know how like routers can like connect router to router to router. I wonder if you could do something like that, like link a bunch of minds together, but like maybe they're not all interconnected, but like you have like an intermediary mind that connects two other minds, and I wonder how that would work.
I imagine that's possible. I mean, if they can do something like this, I think that's almost certainly possible.
I just wonder what's the throughput of like a...
Yeah.
Because at that point, it'd be like the throughput of one person's brain. And I wonder if you can like overload. So imagine like two different like meshes of people, and then that whole mesh is connected by like one person. Would their brain explode?
I don't know. I do know, just going back to like the movie where he did drift with the kaiju, I think he got like a bloody nose and stuff from it, so... You know, it could have been doing some damage to his brain.
Yeah, just the flux of information, well. Or just overstimulation.
Yeah, yeah.
Which leads to another question: why would his nose bleed? If you think too hard, does that increase your intracranial pressure?
I think it's.
I mean, I know it's due to like you know, theatrical effect to show something's happening.
I think. But, yeah. I don't. I mean, maybe who. I don't know if it's so much thinking too hard. Who knows how this information is being put in? Like, if it's like electrical signals, it could just be an overload of that.
Yeah.
You know, causing damage to the brain. Possibly, you'd think there'd be fail safes, but who knows?
Well, so the brain generates like uses a good bit of energy, right? And it generates a lot of heat. So I wonder if you're activating like all of your neurons at once, or like a fair number of neurons.
Do you think that's a fair point? Yeah.
I wonder if you could just through overheat, like your body like activates like an inflammatory response, and that
Yeah.
And since, you know, your brain's very in your brain and your sinuses are very close to each other. Like, it's a very, like, at some point there's like just like a small bone between your brain and your actual like sinus cavity. I mean, you probably could get a bloody nose just from inflammation.
Right? Yeah. And also, I mean, the whole using like 10% of your brain stuff is bullshit, but I mean, there is some truth to it, right? Because you're not activating all of your neurons constantly.
Yeah.
And if you are, you're going to use more energy, which may mean you need to pump more blood in there, which could increase, you know, cranial pressure and, you know, the amount of, like, the blood pressure, which would cause those bleeds.
Well, even like the, like if you're processing at a point where like your brain isn't doing aerobic, like imagine your brain, can brains do anaerobic digestion, like respiration? Because then there'll be a lot of like lactic acid, a lot of those metabolites building up. So that could be like a huge source of something. I mean, definitely increase your acidity.
Also, I do think maybe it's possible that we get a little too caught up on the brain thing. I mean, just your blood pressure being so high from being stressed could cause nosebleeds as well.
Just typical physiological. Yeah, that's a good point. Yeah. I mean, you're that's right. Stress can increase your blood pressure just as is.
Yeah, so you know, there's definitely multiple components that I thought it was probably indicating that it was, you know, affecting his brain in some capacity.
Yeah.
Just because that's like the movie trope, but who knows for sure.
Yeah.
Like, you know, like psychics, like they get like a lot of times they get bloody noses in movies because they overexert their brain.
And in anime, guys see like an intimate part of a female, they get nosebleeds. Like when Naruto does his sexy harem jutsu, you get nosebleeds.
Nice.
Yeah.
And we do know there are psychics in this thing, so this guy could have like some power like that too, where he's able to just dominate someone's mind as well.
Do you think he's like that kid to a degree?
I mean, who knows? He seems like he's probably too old to be like that, but yeah. I mean, who knows for sure? It's possible. It's possible that, you know, he could take some sort of drug that would give him like that ability like temporarily. Yeah. You know, who knows? Just some thoughts. Any other science that we saw that we want to talk about? There wasn't a ton.
There wasn't. Well, we got into like brain physiology. That was pretty fun to a degree.
Yeah.
We don't know much about anatomy that much, so please don't roast us too hard. I haven't taken an anatomy class, but I do generally know. I mean, if you activate your neurons, there are pumps in your like neural cells to like reactivate the electrical pulses in your brain. So like that uses some energy for sure. And it requires some oxygen as well. So, like, if you're not receiving enough oxygen, it's going to use a lot of energy for sure.
Yep. I mean, it's just basic physiology that we're talking about mostly. Anyway, if you guys like the video, make sure you press the like button if you really like it. Make sure you subscribe, and we'll see you next time. Bye.
Bye.